Hi, you're watching the headlines with me. I'm Dipavali Hazra, and this is what's making news. Mission Chandrayaan 2 has taken off for its destination moon from Sriharikota's Satish Dhawan Space Center. ISRO had a shorter launch window today, unlike July the 15th when it was earlier scheduled for liftoff. The first mission was aborted due to a technical glitch. Chandrayaan 2 will now explore the uncharted south pole of the moon. The Karnataka government will face the floor test today. The speaker has asked MLAs to keep the dignity of the house in mind while making their speeches and also to refrain from time-stalling tactics. Earlier, Mayawati had directed her lone BSP MLA to vote for the ruling Congress-JDS coalition. As far as the rebel MLAs are concerned, the speaker has summoned all of them to his office tomorrow. Jammu and Kashmir Governor Satyapal Malik has stirred a huge row by his controversial comments at a public meeting where he said that terrorists should kill corrupt politicians who have looted the state instead of innocent civilians and security personnel. The governor, in his defense, said that his remark was made in a fit of rage. Former Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, Omar Abdullah, was quick to retort to the governor's remarks, saying that Malik had given terrorists the license to kill. First-time BJP MP Pragya Singh Thakur said that she was not elected to clean toilets and drains, but she will do the work she is responsible for honestly. This apparently arrogant remark has drawn backlash as people view her comment being at odds with the Prime Minister's vision. Pragya Thakur was responding to a BJP worker's complaint on cleanliness. MS Dhoni is said to have had a word with Chief Selector MSK Prasad, who is learned to have told the veteran cricketer that he is not in Team India's scheme of things for the long term. Reports say Prasad told Dhoni that selectors were looking to give youngsters a chance and to nurture new talent for the team for the future. Dhoni, however, is not retiring for now, but will skip the Indies tour to serve the Territorial Army. Dozens of masked men in white shirts attacked people returning from a pro-democracy rally in Hong Kong on Sunday. The footage of the attack at the UN Long Station is circulating widely on the internet, with participants in the pro-democracy rally claiming that the police were late to arrive at the scene. Police say they are still investigating and no arrest has been made yet. That's all for now. Stay tuned for more updates.